Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Gene, its nature, expression and regulation. In that, we are studying topic Vogel hypothesis. Remember the codon-anticodon pairing which we have studied? The genetic code says that it should be perfect, but there are certain exceptions to those rules, which is nothing but Vogel hypothesis. Today we'll be studying about that. According to Vogel hypothesis, it means that the first two codons present on mRNA should properly and precisely match with the anticodon present on third RNA. But in case if the third codon present on mRNA does not properly matches with the third anticodon present on tRNA, then it's workable. Then it's fine. Still, the protein will be synthesized. And this was Vogel hypothesis, or you can say Vogel pairing. The third base pair or the third position of the codon or the anticodon is not of that primary importance according to Vogel hypothesis. Now, certain times the third codon or third anticodon could be U, which is GU, or it could be uracil in the case of RNA, mRNA, it could be guanin, it could be adenine, any one of those. We all know that during protein synthesis, mRNA forms the base, and in case of thymine, that is always uracil. So any of the three nucleotides can come at the third position and do a Vogel pairing. Vogel hypothesis. According to Vogel hypothesis, if the first two bases of a codon on mRNA pair precisely with the first two bases of anticodon, but in certain times or in certain cases, if the third position of the base on codon is not matching or not synonymous to the third position of anticodon, then it is a Vogel position. At the third position, either U can be present, A can be present, or G can be present on the mRNA in case of Vogel pairing. Now, this Vogel pairing explains the degeneracy of the code, how genetic code can be little different or it can be little changed. In this diagram, what is shown is normal pairing and Vogel pairing. As you can see, these are nothing but codons. And these are anticodons. In this, the pairing is normal and obvious. A perfect protein would be formed. Whereas in this case, the first two positions are properly paired, but guanin is paired with uracil. That doesn't happen. Guanin pairs with cytosine. And this is an example of Vogel pairing. According to Vogel hypothesis, that the third position nucleotide or third position base is different. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about Vogel hypothesis and how does it function. I hope you all are clear about this concept. Thank you.